Just need to adjust the string, no more.
Oh! Secret in bending the knees.
15 love.
Delightful pick-up on the half volley.
That actually was a very fast serve, 123 miles an hour, and hit flat. Even faster. It doesn't count, but it was going at 125, that one.
30 all.
Just over gilded the lily.
They lead 6-5, second set. First set, Edberg.
Not the worst scenario. A tie break for the Frenchman.
Yes, it's not a bad position to be in, is it, when you're leading 6-5 in a set, because you... you really can gamble in this next game. You know you've got the comfort anyway of a second chance to win the following game, the tie break, of course. And increasing tension for the server, because Edberg's got to come out for the second time now and serve for the set. He made a good job of it in the game before when he served, held it to 15. But it puts quite a lot of pressure on you. Therefore, it is a time for the receiver to gamble, I feel. Chip and charge, that sort of thing.
Time. Love 15.
Well, that's his first.
And he couldn't have picked a much worse time to do it, to choose that first double fault. That's what I meant about the pressure of this game.
H7, the advantage in aces. but it got what it asked for.
15-30.
Forger taking a couple of paces forward. 5-6, 15-30.
Terrific returning in that game by Forger, taking the advantage of having some second serves coming in. In that game, it was absolutely vitally important for Edberg to get his first serve in. And that was the point he won when he did. But when he had to serve second serves, third they set, were just Forger gobbled up by Thank Forger. You. Brilliant returning, settled.
Pretty full stretch.
30-15.
And pretty high tempo from Guy Forger at the moment.
Nothing if not a highly intelligent player is beginning to cover that cross-court backhand now.
40-15. First game, third set, 1-7.
Wasn't that just the most heavenly point ending up in the most beautiful cross-court backhand volley that we've seen in this match, and one of the best I've ever seen. I mean, it was just perfect, hit off a very hard shot from his opponent, Edberg. So let's see that point again. There's that big serve. He's been serving fast. Safely back from Edberg. Cross court, Edberg down the line, and here he comes on the slide, almost going parallel to the net. Had to kill the pace, had to control the ball, put backspin on it, not hit too hard, hit everything in it, and he did it on the slide. Well done, Guy Forget. Set all, and he's now again tight. Ahead. Tight match, very tight.
Overruled by the umpire. Fault was called. And Mr. Watts from the chair said no, it was good. No complaint from Forget.
Game Edberg. One game on.
All the ones. 1 hour and 34 the contest. Comes almost expected.
Fifteen forty.
made to stoop. Not the control that he wanted. Chance for Edberg.
Game Edberg. Edberg leads 2-1, third set. One set all.
It's been a pretty close contest all through, but again, as when he was broken in the previous set, Forget contributing to his downfall with a couple of pretty loose volleys, really.
Yes, they were. They were a surprise, weren't they? Because he has been volleying well. Edberg has been volleying superbly well. And perhaps that's the difference. Both serving pretty satisfactorily. Edberg not as fast as Forget, but perhaps more variety. And as you say, Barry, it is an incredibly tight match. 7-6 first set to Edberg, 7-5 in the tiebreak. Then the second set, 7-5 to Forget. And now this break in the third set with Edberg just putting his nose in front here, but last time he did that, he was broken back to love.
Time. Fifteen love.
Double faults rather creeping into his game now. That's the third. Of course, the last time he was broken, seventh game of the second set, he immediately broke back and went on to take that set.
Oh.
Edberg definitely not serving as well.
15-40.
Two double faults in the game. Thought he'd got it. It's served him very well, that shot. Not then. Still break point.
Juice. Thank you.
Well, can you believe it?
I have hardly Edberg.
Seemed to be Forger's reaction. But in the middle of that rally, there was a really good forehand volley by this man. Point for 3-1.
Game, Edberg. Edberg leads 3-1, third set.
Came the two double faults and some support for the Frenchman.
Fifteen-all. Fifteen-30.
Two more break points. Oh, just died.
30-40. Third set, one set all.
Well, Edberg now suddenly in control after having his doubts with the two double faults. Yes, that control in the third set, coming after he had to battle himself through some not particularly good serving with two double faults to hang on to a break that he'd gained in the third game. And then, having held his service, he's immediately broken again to lead by 4-1. Story of the first two sets, first one going to a tie-break, 7-6 obviously, but the tie-break itself only 7-5. There was no break of service in that first set, and just one break in the tiebreak. Second set, Forger was the first to be broken, but irritated with himself, came roaring back, and with two breaks took it at 7-5.
But here's Edberg, third set, 4-1.
15 love.
Takes him to double figures in the aces department. Contest.
30 love.
Mixing some lovely passing shots with touch play like that. It's come from both men, but at the moment, Forger a little in the doldrums. Perhaps the major difference has been the quality of volleying. Edberg the better, and on both wings too. So problematical as the double faults in the fourth game, which actually put him 15-40 down. Here he's 40-15.
Game, Edward. Edward leads 5-1, third set.
More placement then than power. Forger will want to make his opponent serve out for the set at least.
Almost as an afterthought here, Edberg playing the ball late, hooks it with a lot of wrist. Difficult shot to bring off that. Forger finding that his opponent is hitting a pretty rich vein at the moment. Born in somewhat unlikely circumstances. Suddenly, two set points.
Let first serve.
Just too long.
Juice. Advantage for Jay. Game for Jay. Leads 5-2, third set, 1-7.
And Forger doing well to dig himself out of that position, forcing Edberg to serve for the advantage in sets. And it's not been easier for Forger, because certainly the crowd are on the side of the man who has announced his retirement.
And why indeed has he announced it? This man is the same age, no announcement from him. Other players older in the tournament. He is playing so beautifully of late, Stefan Edberg, that really one wonders whether he could reconsider. But I suppose he does really. I mean, he's had such a glittering career. So many things he's done, including the Junior Grand Slam, which I'm quite sure will never be done by anybody again. And the man who's guided him through most of that, Tony Pickard at the back there, has just come back, not full-time, because he's full-time more with Peter Korda. But he's just helping the old firm, really, back in action, aren't they, Edberg and Pickard. Crowd over his side there, all in the sunshine. Lucky
time.
Them, and so is Stefan Edberg, although he's sitting in the shade, very much in the sunshine. He's just volleyed quite beautifully in this match, and some of his backhand passes have been as good as he's ever done. Forger, an equally nice guy on court, struggling now. Surreptitiously, Edberg has crept through for this lead of 5-2 in this set. So he's got a couple of chances to make it a 2-1 lead.
Love 15.
That's been one of his most telling weapons, is taking that opportunity down the line, blocked on a number of occasions.
15 all.
Somehow a little pleasing when a player of top quality does that.
First time this match, he's done it.
Excellent placement, comfortable volley. 2 set points.
Thank you.
tremendous spirit from Forget. Look, he has to run right from outside one tram line to inside the next. Great control on the run. He is absolutely not giving up this set without a fight.
Extravagantly long.
Game, third set, Edberg. 6-2. Edberg leads 2-1. Fourth set. Forget to serve.
2 minutes short of the 2 hours. Edberg winning sets 1 and 3. Forget to start the fourth. And start it with such deftness.
15-love. Oof. 15-all.
The umpire not overruling, given in 15-all.
Let first serve. Juice.
It is the difference. He's made more errors with his volleying. Point is relative, but it's made the difference.
Advantage, Edberg.
Chance of an early break. The Frenchman a little languid in coming in then.
Juice.
Thank you.
Cardiff Edberg.
For the first time, Forger in conversation with Forger. Allez, 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 he was saying to himself.
Game, Forger. New balls, please.
Escapes the two break points, and the ace takes him into the lead in the fourth
first
set.
First game, fourth set. Edberg leads 2-2.
Well, the crowd still massive for this match. It really is a good tennis match, too. Some wonderful tennis being played in it. It's been on court for over 2 hours now, 2 hours and 4 minutes.
Well, that opening game actually contained a moment when we had a query of a call for the first time, but the query came from both players.
Yes, but Edberg hit the ball in. The ball was the score was called in his favour. He then seemed to be querying with the umpire whether that was fair. Well, of course,
time.
Every year the sportsmanship award goes to Edberg, except for 2 years when he went to Todd Martin. I mean, it's been renamed that sportsmanship award, the Stefan Edberg Sportsmanship Award. So it's the sort of behaviour you expect from him.
Lovely line about him from a former Times correspondent, Rex Bellamy. He said that he realizes that everybody is important and nobody is very important. Here he is, love one, full set.
Love 50.
Measuring of the height of the net, or has it just come undone? Yes, it's come undone, but even so. check now.
First serve.
That is meticulous. It's done, of course, at the end of every set, and it's even. The nine judge at the very back in the center there will tell the man at the net if that tape is absolutely straight and vertical.
Game, Edberg. One game in, full set. Love 15.
Noticeable that the forehand volley from Forger, just a little suspect. The backhand, fine.
15 all.
Some doubt this time about the serve. Swish and hope.
Full set. Edberg, two sets to one.
It's been a match so far, Bill, where the crowd has admired the quality of play, felt a little bit on the side of Edberg, but they haven't got that involved, have they?
No, it hasn't absolutely caught fire, no. In fact, the most noise they made, I thought, was when the two players walked onto court, and obviously they were directing all that love and affection and noise at Stefan Edberg. But there have been some wonderful points played. This last one was good, wasn't it? Forger serving there into the body. Edberg moving for where he thought it would go. It doesn't. Just digs it up. And Forger has no option but to hang his racket out and bang it back from whence it came. But great skills. I mean, these players are playing with their minds as well as their bodies and their feet. They really are working out how to play each other. They've already played each other 12 times. They're 6 all in matches played. But they're learning a bit more about each other now. Because Edberg has a great ability of late to volley behind the other player instead of to the empty court. He's doing that far more in the last year or so than I've seen him do before.
Thank you.
And consequently, he's volleying very well indeed. 22 successful volleys he's played in this match.
Keep it going.
15 love.
Stays at 22 successful volleys. Looked like a 23rd, but Forger had other ideas.
Here he is smashing behind the other player. Once again, wrong footing.
15 all.
30-15. Edberg not wanting to interrupt his conversation.
Game, Edberg. Two games all, fourth set. Fifteen.
An almighty wallop. And again, Edberg not too sure. No bleep. Sometimes if the serve is very long, it's out of the ray. Oh yes, and he's a bit pumped up now, Stefan Edberg.
Well, I just had the feeling this was very slightly lucky. It was as good as he meant it. He no doubt meant it, but my word, that was just perfect, wasn't it? And it's break point.
Two sets to one.
Well, earlier in the match, Bill, I thought it was Forget who turned irritation to his advantage. And here we've had exactly the same with Edberg. I think you thought that he was complaining about a net cord, and you were probably right on that. And from that moment, having not got his way, he was really up and going for it.
Yes, when Edberg talks to an umpire, he looks sort of puzzled. You're not sure whether he's seething inside or not, really. He's always, of course, polite. I believe he was querying the net cord, which I'm not sure always works totally accurately. Sometimes, some of these tournaments where it's been used, the players have felt they've served, you know, like a foot over the net, and it's still given a bleep. So I suppose everything that's engineering or electrical can go wrong, and it's just possible it can. However, I don't think it was too serious an argument he was having with the umpire, Barry, so it'd be extremely unlike Stefan Edberg if it was. In a really good position now, two sets to one up and a break in the fourth.
Oh, so
time.
Back to that article I was talking about earlier. That only by his brilliance has Edberg ever been known to put his opponent off, never ever seeking an unfair advantage. Here he is, 3-2. And leading by two sets to one.
Love 50. Let first off.
Net court actually helped Guy Forget, but he used it very well.
15-30. Oh. 40-30. Game, Edberg. Edberg leads 4-2, fourth set.
The number 12 seed closing in on the place in the second round. He's at 22 on the computer, and his opponent here 51.
Love 15.
Just a bit of fallibility in that forehand volley in the last set or two.
Fifteen all.
He pretty ambitious. It was quite a low ball.
Fifteen forty.
Virtual match point. Point for a 5-2 lead for Stefan Edberg. Has to find another good serve.
Let for serve. Juice.
And an over-impulsive surge forward by Edberg then, trying to volley the volley, but he never even reached it. Full marks for trying. Smooth backhand passes, the timing just exquisite, really restrained because he couldn't hit too hard.
Advantage Fourier.
This is not hit and hope. This is absolutely directed to go across the body. Forehand working very well. He must be so pleased with that.
Third break point.
Go!
let second serve.
Bit of a dribbler. Quite superb returns of service by Stefan Edberg. Second, his more favoured backhand
Edberg
down the line.
Five games to two, fourth set, and by 2 sets to 1.
And he's been coming here since 1983, and he is so eager to get the victory here.
He's like a young boy, isn't he? A junior. So enthusiastic, trying so hard for every point. And he had to wait for confirmation there. He's hit some blistering passes in this game. Focus on that ball then. Is it in? Yes. He's absolutely fired up. He's played a terrific match. My word, it's going to need somebody good unless he goes off form in this tournament to put him out, assuming he wins this. He's coming out to serve for it. He is going to get a terrific applause.
It was a lovely line by Boris Becker at Queen's Club.
Time.
Edberg said, see you next week. And he said, no, in 2 weeks.
Did he? Good for him. Started already, Barry. He's just going to ride the wave now.
Serving for the match. Oh. And the gods are on his side as well.
15 love.
He's contributed much, Keith Forger, but not as consistently as his opponent. Second serve.
Yeah, well, it's right in the zone. He must have hit 30. About 20 of these, really, from the right court. Edberg, I don't think, should be serving there. It's right in his nice hitting zone. He's very good at that shot. Better to serve straight at him or on the forehand, I feel. Yes, it's... It's not as dangerous. I feel that Forger backhand, he really has hit some wonderful shots off that side. Mainly on return of serve.
Takes Edberg to match point.
Thank you.
Top of the wall.
Juice.
Do I have a sense of deja vu, Guy Forget, Jeremy Bates? Did we not study that match together, Barry?
Yes, we did indeed.
Let first up.
Don't think this man, though, will let it go.
Edberg.
Second chance.
Yes, yes. Set now, Edberg. 7-6, 5-7, 6-2, 6-2.
Fittingly. Won by a volley, and on this particular day, the forehand volley, every bit as good as the backhand. Good contest for the purists, lasting 2 hours and 35 minutes. It was tight for so long, and then Edberg pushed on for victory.
Ladies and gentlemen, in the interest of security, may we remind spectators to take all property with you when leaving your seats or viewing positions. Please do not leave property.